Hello again, and welcome back to the channel. On this outing we're fishing a few spots between Uvongo and Ramsgate. The water has a bit of colour to it from the rains last night. The rivers are running a bit, but not bad at all, definitely fishable. Taking a slow stroll down the garden route to check out the fishing holes. The water temperature is at 19 degrees today, maybe a little on the cooler side. The barometer is at 1020 and falling, so conditions are not ideal for bites.
Nice little hold on, yeah?
Some good looking spots along this stretch, worth a try in the future when conditions are good again. The fishing spots are a bit elevated along this stretch of coast. I will have to watch my footing here. These rocks are slippery when wet. Looks promising for a fish catch, lovely little beach as well.
We're doing this tennis ball for the back of the rod. The tennis ball for the back of the rod. Don't you use a bucket?
For me?
Yeah.
I'm using the bucket sometimes.
Sometimes. Now look how nicely that sits.
Yeah.
It sits very nicely. It doesn't come off easily at all. And it makes such a nice cushioning.
Yes.
I don't like a bucket, so this cushions so nicely for me.
Yeah.
Look at it.
Yes.
Lovely. It's a baby pig nose grunter.
This is a little pig nose grunter or white mussel cracker. The elevation is a bit high, so the fish are airborne, unfortunately. We will figure out a way of landing the fish in a better way. It's a bit high and rough water for the use of a net.
Lovely.
Watch the spines and gill plates. This is a thorny fish,
so,
and you could
this
easily
is a lovely
end up
little
with a puncture
pig nose
or cut from the gill plates.
So this is a lovely little pig nose. It's a baby pig nose grunter.
It's a grunter.
See him?
He's
There it is, off. Got him. Nice little one, and he's got to go back. This break he's going to get bigger.
This one took a sardine and squid bait.
It's a cat face, rock rod. Exactly where I told you you were going to catch it.
Exactly.
It's a cat face rock cod. The minimum size is 50 centimeters, and you are allowed 5 per person per day.
I don't know.
This one is a short, coming in at a measurement of 44 centimeters.
This one is 44 centimeters. But I don't know what the size
of this.
You can put it in the pool.
Yeah. Special day.
Probably a place here under the mouth that you can pick up.
Okay.
See here. See there.
Yes.
There. Pick up there. On the one hook, I'm going to try straight up prawn, and I think on the other one we will try a little bit of mix, a bit of baby squid, try a little bit of little bit of baby squid and prawn mixed. Black or white squid, so still nice and fresh. Let's see if we get any results on that. I like to just cut it in half. Now this one doesn't have a head on it, unfortunately, but we've still got a bit of juice there. And cut that in half again. Give this a bit of a pounding. That one on the bottom hook. Let's get a little piece of prawn on. That opened up. Prawns aren't that big. Are we going to do a double up?
There we go. Nothing big. But it is a fish.
Yes.
Nothing big, but it is a fish. Ready.
On with another fish. This one is a stone bream, also known as a mooney. I don't normally keep stone bream. I decided to keep this one for the pan. I was told that they're good eating too. I bleed the fish and it turned out to be very good tasting. They are now on the menu.
It's a nice one.
What's going on? Nothing happening.
Quiet.
I'm going to put one in right here. Water's cold, eh? 19. Barometer sitting at 1,020. But it's falling. So things are not too good.
Other marine creatures. The amount of line left on the rocks in this area is not good, so we remove it whenever we see it. I guess it comes with being a popular holiday destination.
Here comes a big one, eh? Gonna get wet. Here come the sets. Well, apparently I'm gonna get wet too.
Just the taste.
Look at that for a catch, guys. Good sized crayfish, and it is full of berry. Have a look at this. Caught on the hook, full of berry. Let's get this girl off the hook. Back in the water. It just shows still a couple of nice crayfish around here. What a lovely crayfish. Let's see if we can get this one off the hook here. Give us the pliers here. Let's try and get it off, get this hook out. Look, it's full of eggs. I don't know, we'll have to do a little bit of an operation here without doing any damage.
Push it in. In.
No, well, hang on, I don't want to damage the thing. No, we'd have to do a little bit of an operation here with art.
Almost art. There we go.
There we go, coming out. Almost out. There we go. Thank you.
direction. Yeah.
Last one.
On with another fish, a good-sized bronze bream, aka blue fish. This one fell for a combo prawn and squid bait.
Careful.
Ready.
Yeah. Ready.
That's a
nice size bream there, guys. That's a good 2 kilos there. Very nice. That's a proper size bream, eh?
Yeah. It is a proper size.
Yeah, let's get him off the hook. There he is, guys. Good size, that one. He's coming home for the frying pan. There are no doubts about that.
AVR with a good sized bronzie. Unfortunately, his GoPro battery died and he didn't get the landing footage. A good bronze bream nonetheless.
Very nice, very nice. It's even bigger than my one.
Yeah.
I just had a very nice bite here as well. Very nice.
About a 3 kg, 3.5.
Beautiful fish, baby. Well done, well done. Nice. Another one for the fan, eh?
Loosen it a little bit if it's too tight. Loosen the
AV scaling and gutting the fish for a catch clean and cook tonight. Fish and a few prawns done in butter, garlic, salt and pepper are on the menu.
You can see the bronze colour there, eh? Look at
that.
Yeah. Look how bronze that is.
You can see when it's come out there. Isn't it?
That one was very dark, eh?
Yeah.
It's a very bronzy colour. It's a very good eating fish. See the bronze colour there, eh?
Yeah.
Look how bronze that is.
You can see when it's come out there, isn't it?
That one was very dark, eh?
Yeah.
It's very bronze. What's in the stomach? Just check the stomach contents there. Check the stomach contents. What is inside the stomach?
Look how fat is it.
Yeah, see, it's very fat. But what's in the stomach? What's it been eating?
It was eating the grass.
Well, pull it out. Let's have a look. Just open it up a bit so we can see what it's been eating.
Look, it's very fat.
That you can eat the liver and the heart.
Yeah.
But what is that? Let's have a look.
It's a grass. Which is the biggest?
This one. The one I caught is the biggest. Very nice.
I'll put it on a plate so you can see. Ready to fry. Okay, now we're putting the flour on nicely.
That's just normal head flour.
Yeah.
What do you use this?
Okay, I'm going to put it in.
Flour and then into the egg. Just wash it.
Frying pan.
So you don't get that pressure in this because that was swimming just a few hours ago.
Yes, and now it's swimming.
So we're going to do a little bit of prawn on the side as well with the fish. Get some butter melted. Just put a dollop of olive oil in it. A dollop. More. Excellent. Put the garlic bread in. Leave it. Prawns as well. Oh, these are so nice and firm. I say they're so nice and firm. Prawns as well, you don't want to. You don't want to overdo them. Look at this. Lovely prawns. Lovely green. Wow. Prawn, butter. Absolutely. That bluefish.